Hey, Jonathan here, and in this video, I'm going to show you a template that we created based on our time at Duke for more easily organizing your scholarly reading. So if you want to just stop this video and go grab that template right now, please feel free. The link is in the description, and all you have to do is click the link. You'll be taken to this page right here, and it's completely free. You can just put in zero right here, then click I want this. And then you will just share your email and we will send you an email invitation to access the template shortly after. And that's it. You'll be set to go. You can use it, do whatever you want with it. And if you want to stick around for the rest of the video, I will walk you through the template and explain why we designed it in this way. I'll share a real life example of how we're using this template, and I'll show you how you can use it with Notion if you're a Notion person. So I will get off of video here so we can focus on the template. And that's exactly what you're looking at right here. This is the organizer for scholarly reading template, and it came out of a pain point that I'm sure you've experienced. We experienced this a ton while we were doing researching and writing and analysis at Duke, where the more resources you have and the more analysis you're conducting, the more tabs, applications, windows you're accumulating, piling up, you're spending a bunch of time bouncing around between multiple different resources. There's PDFs and Word docs flying around, and it's overall just chaotic and frustrating to actually find the information you're looking for and make the most of it. And you're spending more time looking for things that you've already found than actually being able to sit down, read, and take notes and synthesize the information. And so that's exactly why we created the template and the platform in this way, where you have a split screen interface where you have your reading and writing in a single space, in a single window. So on the left hand side, you can upload all of your reference materials. So you are able to either download PDFs, Word documents, etc., put them into the template, or you can clip web pages and put them and save them into the hub as well. And then you can organize them into the pre-built out folders, or you can change up the folders, you can delete them, you can add new ones, you can do whatever you want here. It's totally up to you, and it's customizable. And then on the right hand side is where you can write and you can take notes on the reading. And better yet, you can actually connect your notes on the right hand side to your references on the left so that you know exactly where everything's coming from. You're never losing track of information. You don't have to squint to figure out where a file is located because the link remembers it for you. And I'll show you exactly how that works in the real life example that we are using this template for. So this is research that we are conducting on patient centricity. And so we are constantly reading articles and documents around the topic and uploading them in here. And the way we organize them is through smart links. So the way that that works is you'll right click the link, select open link, and then boom, it automatically pulls up that file right here so that you don't have to remember where it's coming from. You know exactly what the source is for this specific note. And you can do that for all of your files and all of your notes. So it's a fantastic way to organize your reading, your notes, and connect your notes to your reading all in one place. And if you want to create a smart link, that is super easy as well. All you have to do is highlight the text you want to create the link to, click the smart link button right here, and then you'll have this menu where it says choose upload. You click the upload that you want, hit save, and then you're done. Now there's a link. You won't have to remember where the information comes from ever again because it remembers it for you. And as I mentioned, this works super well with Notion. If you already use Notion or are looking to use Notion, or it's a part of your workflow, whatever the case may be, it works great because you can embed the template directly into Notion. So as you see, this is another hub that we created based on that template, this time around sustainability research. And as you can see, it fits perfectly into your Notion space. And we use Notion to organize a bunch of these hubs. And another great thing about Notion and Kahana is that Kahana actually allows you to work around the 5 megabyte upload limit that Notion's free plan has. So if you're familiar with the plan, you might know that Notion only allows you to upload files that are up to 5 megabytes in size. But in a Kahana hub, you can upload files that are up to 100 megabytes in size. So you could upload multiple files into your hub and then embed the hub into Notion. So it's a great way to get around that, a nice little hack there. And yeah, that is pretty much it. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this helps organize your scholarly reading and materials. If you have any questions for us or have any feedback, please feel free to reach out to us. We're including our socials in the description. And again, the link to the template is in the description as well. Just click it, share your email, and we will get you access as soon as possible. So hope this helps and have a wonderful rest of your day.